Dear students, in our last class we discussed the condition for light amplification. And today we are going to discuss about the line shape function. For the sake of simplicity, we have assumed till now that the emission of light by all atoms in the specimen is strictly monochromatic and the frequency is given by nu equals E2 minus E1 by H. But this is not actually true. The actual frequency of light, although centered at a frequency nu zero, it has a spread over a certain range delta nu. We cannot express the frequency of the light emitted in a single frequency, or could not express it in terms of a center frequency nu zero, but we can represent it over a range of frequency delta nu, and this delta nu is called as the line width. And this line width is defined as the frequency corresponding to the intensity half I, that is frequency corresponding to half of the intensity. So line width is defined as the frequency corresponding to the intensity half I. And we can say that the atoms can interact with radiation over a range of frequency, and the strength of the interaction is a function of frequency, and it is called as, and we can say that the atoms can interact with the radiations over a range of frequencies, and this function is known as the line shape function. The line shape function is represented using G omega, and this function, line shape function G omega, is normalized so we can write the normalization condition, that is minus infinity to plus infinity G omega d omega equals 1. Here we have explained the emission of light. Similarly, atoms are capable of absorbing light, not just at a single frequency, but also over a band of frequency. We can explain the absorption also. So atoms are capable of absorbing light not just at a single frequency, but over a range of frequency or over a band of frequency. And we can say that the atoms interact with light over a range of frequency. So if you plot a graph with intensity as a function of frequency, we would get a bell-shaped graph as shown in this figure. So the plot of intensity as a function of frequency is bell-shaped, and the shape of the curve is described by the line shape function G omega. Let us consider there are n1 number of atoms in the ground state and n2 number of atoms in the excited state. Out of the n2 number of atoms, out of the total n2 and n1 atoms per unit volume, n2 g omega d omega and n1 g omega d omega atoms per unit volume will be capable of interacting with radiation. So even though there are n1 and n2 number of atoms per unit volume, only n2 g omega d omega and n1 g omega d omega atoms per unit volume will be capable of interacting with radiation of a frequency lying between omega and omega plus d omega. Or we can represent it using the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu. We have already derived the expression B21 as pi square CQ by H cross omega cube A21. This can also be written as pi square CQ by H cross omega cube into tau SP. Here A21 equals 1 by tau sp, or we can say tau sp equals 1 by A21, and tau sp equals 1 by A21 represent the spontaneous lifetime of the upper level. So number of stimulated emissions per unit time per unit volume into frequency range omega and omega plus d omega can be written as W21 equals into integral B21 u omega g omega d omega. Here substitute B21 equals pi square c cube by h cross omega cube tau sp. Then we can write W21 equals into integral pi square c cube by h cross omega cube tau sp into u omega g omega d omega. Taking the constant terms outside the integral, we can write W21 equals into pi square c cube by h cross tau sp integral u omega by omega cube g omega d omega. Let this be equation number 3. Now we can consider some special cases. Case 1. Suppose that the atoms are interacting with radiation whose spectrum is very broad compared to that of G omega. So first case is that we consider atoms interacting with the radiation whose spectrum is very broad compared to that of G omega. Its representation can be shown as in figure 1. Then we can assume that over the region of interaction where G omega is appreciable, then here the term which is inside the integral, that is U omega by omega cube, is a constant. So the case when atoms interacts with radiation whose spectrum is very broad compared to G omega, then we can take the term U omega by omega cube inside the integral to outside, as it is considered as a constant, and hence the expression for W21 becomes W21 equals into pi square by c cube h cross tau sp, taking u omega by omega cube outside the integral, that is u omega by omega cube integral g omega d omega. Integral g omega d omega equals 1. So therefore we can write W21 equals into pi square c cube by h cross tau sp omega cube into u omega. Let this be equation number 4. Or we can write W21 equals into B21 u omega, because from equation 2 B21 equals pi square c cube by h cross omega cube into 1 by into tau sp. So substituting the value of equation 2, we can write equation 4 as W21 equals into B21 u omega, and this equation 4 is same as the equation obtained earlier. Thus equation 4 represents the rate of stimulated emission per unit volume when the atom interacts with broadband radiation. So when atoms interact with broadband radiation, equation 4 represents the equation for rate of stimulated emission per unit volume. Now let us consider the second case. Here we assume that the atom is interacting with near monochromatic radiation. So, and here if the frequency of the incident radiation is omega dash dash, then we can write the U omega curve will be extremely sharply peaked at omega equals omega dash compared to G omega. So suppose that the atom is interacting with near monochromatic radiation, then the U omega curve will be extremely sharply peaked at omega equals omega dash as compared to G omega. It is shown in this second figure. it is shown. So under this condition, we can take chi omega by omega cube term outside the integral of equation 3. Thus the expression W21 becomes N2 pi square C cube by H cross tau SP G omega dash by omega dash cube integral U omega D omega. Here G omega dash represent the value of line shape function evaluated at the radiation frequency omega dash. So let us consider integral U omega D omega equals U. Therefore we can write the expression of W21 equals N2 pi square C cube by H cross omega dash cube tau SP into G omega dash U. Let this be equation number 5. U equals integral U omega D omega, where integral U omega D omega is written as U. And it is the energy density of incident monochromatic radiation. So U equals integral U omega D omega is the energy density of the incident monochromatic radiation. Here U has the dimensions of energy per unit volume, whereas U has the dimension of energy per unit volume, whereas U omega has the dimensions of energy per unit volume per unit frequency interval. And so equation 5 gives the stimulated emission rate per unit volume when an atom described by a line shape function G omega interacts with near monochromatic radiation at frequency omega dash. Similarly, in a similar manner, the number of stimulated absorption per unit time per unit volume will be W12 equals N1 pi square C cube by H cross omega dash cube tau SP into G omega dash U. That's all.